Okay.
Bye.
Oh my God.
So we're gonna attach that now to an email. Now you're in an email already. And so then I like to
almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home.
My advice today is we're about to enter a 5-day off from school next week. Actually, you count Saturday, Sunday, and then 5 days at 7, and then Saturday, Sunday again. We'll have about 9 or 10 days off from school. So my advice to you is to be safe. I hope you enjoy yourself and just forget about school. If you're behind in school, maybe it would behoove you to maybe get caught up a little bit. But if you're all caught up, just sit back and relax and go with the wave. The wave. Just float in the waves from the Great Salt Lake and enjoy yourself.
I think if I were to give any advice about mental health as we come into the last few weeks of school, is finishing strong. We just started the term a few weeks ago. Making sure you get your assignments done will reduce anxiety. Having a fun and safe spring break will be epic for everybody. And when you come back, there's 7 weeks of school left, so finish strong. And follow through with the things that you know you're supposed to do, and take care of yourself. Do some self-care. Make sure that you're taking care of your emotions, your family, yourself, getting enough sleep, eating right, so that you can be healthy. And I would say that's my advice for this month.
What is the best prank that someone has pulled on you?
Okay, well, about 2 minutes ago, Colby jumped out of the equipment closet with the scary mask on, and I almost peed my pants.
That's nice. What is the best prank that has been pulled on you?
My brother was making these little chocolate balls that day, and I ate one, and it was like a real egg.
Oh, tough. What is the best prank that's been pulled on you?
One time I was taking a nap, and Landon, Stacy, my older siblings, and me being innocent, just a little kid, taking a nap like I'm supposed to. They dump whipped cream all over my face and get a feather and tickle me, and I rub it all over, and I get it all over the bed sheets. And
classic prank. Pretty lame, but thanks for saying that. What is the best prank that has been pulled on you?
I don't know the best prank, but I will tell you a prank that they tried to pull on me. It was a teacher years and years and years ago across the hall where Marvel is now. It was April Fool's, and one of the students came running in my room, and they're like, "Something happened to Nielsen. She's passed out. Something's wrong. She's laying on the ground and she's not moving." So I'm like, okay, it's April Fool's, you know. But I walk over and I was like, "Nielsen, get off the ground." The students just laughed. I'm like, it's April Fool's.
Can you imagine if it was like real and you're just like, get up?
Yeah, I was like, it was April Fool's. I'm like, come on. Yeah, you gotta do better than that.
Yeah, you gotta have a good actor go in and do that.
You can't just send
any student.
And especially like on April Fool's, you gotta top it somehow.
Like a week before.
You could do it on April Fool's, just not that one. Like, of course, that's April Fool's.
Yeah.
So yeah, anyway, that's what I got.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
What is the best prank that you have pulled on someone?
Well, one time, a kid fell asleep in my class. So I had the whole class. We were done for the day. We had like 10 minutes left. So we turned off the lights. They all grabbed their backpacks, and we set the clock to be like 3 p.m. And then we went out in the hallway and hid. And we had Misty call down to my classroom so it'd wake him up. And he like jumped up, and he was like, "Ah," and sprinted out, and we were all sitting there laughing, and it was great.
Ah, baby, don't mess around. Hey guys, I have Ethan here with me today. What is the best prank you have pulled on someone?
During Thanksgiving dinner, we were all at my sister's house, and my other sister bought poppets, and I lined the toilet seat with a box of them, and then someone sat on them, and then they all went off.
That's good. Hello. So, I'm with Lucy.
I'm Lucy.
That's Lucy.
This is Lucy.
So, what is the best prank that you have pulled on someone before?
I wouldn't say it's the best, but when my brother Isaac would shower, the door to the bathroom is like right next to my other brother's door. So I'd open them a little bit, and then I'd tie them together. So when one of them would try to leave the room, they'd just, like, keep slamming the doors. Anyways, that's it.
Nice.
Hey, yeah, we fancy like Applebee's on a date night. That's a Bourbon Street steak with the Oreo shake and some whipped cream on the top too. Two straws, one check, girl, I got you. Bougie like Natty in the styrofoam. Squeeze squeaking in the truck bed all the way home. So Alabama jam, she my Dixieland delight. That's how we do, how we do. Fancy like my new clean blue jeans without the holes in them. Country kisses on my lips without the skull in them. Yeah, she probably gonna be keeping some Victoria's Secrets.
Welcome back to Get Nerdy with Hannah. I'm here with my wonderful Star Trek bestie, Bartier.
Hi, everyone.
And we have Tilly, the chicken. And so, first news, I found out, like, the day after our segment, my segment was done, they casted Paul Wesley as...
Jim Kirk,
James Tiberius Kirk. I'm like,
So it's going to be interesting to see on Star Trek Discovery, isn't it?
It's going to be weird because it's for season two, and it's going to be weird for
Discovery, it's Picard. It's not Picard. No, which one is it? I'm sorry. There's so many of them.
Yeah, there are so many of them. It's Discovery because Spock's in it.
Oh, Discovery. Okay.
Yes, because Spock.
Sure. Okay, yes.
Spock, we love him. And, like, they already, like, casted, like, a Uhura for, and they sent out, like, little videos of each character. I'm like, ooh, it's going to be entertaining.
Yeah, so.
And for the fans of Vampire Diaries, I know, it's going to be weird not seeing him as a vampire.
Yeah, but I think it's an interesting cast choice, but interesting in a good way,
yes.
Not a bad way. So.
Interesting in a good way, not like a really bad way.
Yeah.
But I'm excited.
Yeah, so what else is coming up? What do we have forward to look forward to?
And for all my Stranger Things fans, May 26th is when it comes back.
That is so soon.
That's so soon.
That would be a great way to kick off summer vacation, though, to, like...
Yes.
And I think they release all the episodes in one go.
They release half the season in one go, and then they release the other season in July.
Oh, okay. Well, then you can, like, binge half the season then in one go, which I guess is nice. I don't know.
I like it. And my Marvel fans, Ms. Marvel comes out June 8th.
Ms. Marvel. Okay, so after you finish binging Stranger Things, the first half of the fourth season, then you can go
watch
Ms. Marvel. Although I've noticed that for Disney Plus, when it comes to, like, their shows, they do it week by week.
Yeah, episode, weekly. Really. It's so weird. I like it.
Yeah, it's interesting.
Older than the trees, young.